Thank you for joining us on such a beautiful day. And I'm happy that you're here, and we're happy that we're here. So, my name is Richard Corrigan, on behalf of Eli, and the rest of the orchestra, and you're welcome. Hope you enjoyed the show. Our first piece, by Rossini. Many of you may know if you ever watched any cartoons, but this one wasn't a cartoon. But you can still get the same flavor, the same feel. It's undeniable you recognize this character.
Thank you.
somewhat solitary figure. Several years ago, there was a book by Dan Brown, the Da Vinci Code, where they discussed a secret society that was all supposed to be, you know, it's all real based on facts. Well, in fact, Debussy was the grand master of that secret society at one point. So he was the keeper of the ancient scrolls. And so anyhow, this fellow, Debussy, he did not, neither did develop, like the term impressionist, even though that was how they were all labeled at that point. He considered himself a symbolist. Like the book, there are symbols hiding throughout art and throughout the Millennium writing. Well, his music also has a certain mystical quality that he hides in. Some pieces that some of the doctors say have much deeper, more hidden meanings. This piece, arranged by Maurice Ravel, who's the next generation. One thing I mentioned in the program is Maurice Ravel is considered to be a fine orchestrator, in fact, being the very best of all of them. And this was his early project. He also did another piece, Dot Dance, by Hope.
Thank you. Thank you.
took his violin and his bow and went to the orchestra. And it was not good. Like, he had no sense of melody, he was never in pitch, he was, you know, had no sense of phrasing. So they said, okay, we'll give you another stick. We're going to put you in the back of the percussion for us. And we're going to have to play the percussion. But it wasn't any better. There was no sense of rhythm, kept playing like really big sounds when it was supposed to be soft. And it was just, okay, one last chance. We're going to take away one of your sticks. And they sent him up front to be the conductor. So all of the pieces on our program today have a really strong sense of storytelling. I've been the part of opera, right, which is the piece that we begin and end the concert with, where they're part of a bigger story. Like the music that you just heard was one of the reasons why it was composed was to memorialize the Finnish struggle for independence from the Soviet Union, which is, you know, something that happened a long time ago, but it's that same message of struggle against a larger power that is infested, you know, never more relevant, and it's an eternal message, I think. This next composer, Samuel also had his own struggles. He was a contemporary of Gustav Mahler, and died right around the time that World War I was starting to drum up his rhythm. And he was a composer of African descent who was based mostly in Great Britain, so he found immense inspiration when he came to the States and encountered African spirituals and the spirit of the Black band in America. The piece that he wrote today, one of the things that I appreciate so much about it is that it has such a strong and vivid sense of storytelling. It's split into four movements. The first movement is called Caprice of Nenet. So caprice, of course, coming from the word capricious, which means whimsical, and kind of prone to flights of fancy, and just very imaginative. The second movement is called Request and Response. And in it, you'll hear someone asking, someone responding, and it's kind of up to the listener to figure out what's being asked and what the response is. The third movement is entitled very simply a sonnet to love, or of love, sonnet of love. And the very last movement is called a tarantella, which was a form of dance that was characterized by a lot of growling, by a lot of constant movement, and it's the second part of the title that's moving. Literally translated, it translates to wiggling. So I'll leave it to you to make what sense of that that you will.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.